Vetri Vel Muruganaka, Hari Ram, and warm welcome to Sadhana, the Inward Path. Yes, the vibrations of Deepavali still linger on, and you can find all the excitement right here on 3 as we celebrate the Festival of Lights in Phoenix and soak in the powerful energy of Ram Bhajans in Merebank. But first, we get fully absorbed in the divine at the Sri Siva Subramanya Temple in Clairwood. The mysterious arrival of a holy man gave birth to the Clairwood Sri Siva Subramanya Temple 125 years ago. While the temple underwent some revamps in recent times, much of the original structures still remain. Sadhana joined devotees for their Mahakumbha Abhishegam, which formed part of their anniversary celebrations.
The first indentured labourers settled in the Clairwood area as free Indians in about 1889. And they found that there was a holy man roaming around in Clairwood and near the bridge in Buckus Road. They found him meditating with just a lingam, and it was under a tree. When they looked for him, they couldn't find him again. But he had left behind the lingam and a veil fashioned out of wire. And they set up the first wooden iron temple there. That was around 1889.
The presiding deity of the temple is Siva Subramani, which is Murugan. That presiding deity sits on our main temple. Together with that, the other deities, we have our Ganesha, our Mahavishnu. On the extreme right is our Hidaman temple. On my extreme left is our Amman temple. My left again is the Hanuman temple, the Madhaviran temple, and the Ganesha temple.
Everything that is here is modeled and fashioned around the original structure. The main gobrams, the three main gobrams and the Murugan temple, those are the original. And everything that you see that's been built has been built around the original, because those domes have been declared a heritage site by the Etekpinin municipality and Amafa. All the murtis that we have in the Mulastanams are all the original murtis that were brought from India in the 1920s. We want to leave that for many, many generations still to come. The power in this temple comes from those original murtis.
As we celebrate our 125 years of existence, and we saw it appropriate that we needed to beautify and glorify this temple in many different forms. We are performing the Kumbha Abhishegam and Mandala Abhishegam. The Kumbha Abhishegam is an Hindu ritual that is believed to energize and unite the mystic powers of the presiding deity.
It's a wonderful prayer that when you get involved and you're fasting and you're sitting in the havans, you feel the vibrations in the temple and you know that the presence of God is there if you want to tap into it. We have 5 avankuns in the veranda, and we will have 5 different priests chanting the mantras for each of the 5 deities that each of those kuns represent. And we will have all of them chanting at the same time in order to create those vibrations and invite, our loving deities.
And then we will go up to the main domes, which is your gobram. They will perform a ritual called the Abhishegam, where they will pour the sanctified water onto the domes. They will do that for the entire temple and all the domes and the temples. That's basically a consecration process.
The power in this temple just seems to grow from day to day, from year to year. You know, there are a lot of people from Clairwood, because of the group areas that have been removed to other areas like Chatsworth and Phoenix and all of those places. But you only need to be here at our big prayers, particularly the Kavadi, when you find old Clairwood people from wherever in South Africa they've moved to, whether they're in Joburg or Phoenix or wherever. They all come back. This is a meeting place for old family and friends.
Welcome back to Sadhana. Our places of worship and traditions were brought here by our forefathers, but have been preserved by the current generation of the time. 154 years later, and the baton has been passed on to our present generation of youth, who have made remarkable strides in keeping our rich Hindu heritage alive and vibrant. Youth just like those from the Sri Devam Bhajan group in Merebank.
The Devam Bhajan group first came along in 2009, around February. So it's been 5 years fast, five good long years.
Look, we're more or less like parents to these boys, like taking them off from hanging around the streets, getting around with that company, and some of them may not listen to their parents. So we actually stepped in to take the place of the parents, because most of the parents are at work. And we counseled them, and we took it upon ourselves to open this bhajan group and keep them out of mischief.
We have weekly practice that's on a Tuesday, and we basically pray for different prayers. We pray for Kavadis, we pray for Aman prayers, and we pray for Hanuman prayers as well. So that keeps us quite occupied for most of the weekends.
Some of the things we do as a bhajan group, we go around feeding, doing the feeding schemes, and we go around collecting toys for these underprivileged children, and then we pick up clothes to feed, to help the poor. And there are lots of other things that we do.
We saw a great change in one of our boys, where he started where he wasn't in a good place at that time in his life. So we took him into the bhajan, and today he's making some, he's no more in the group, unfortunately, he's moved to Joburg, but he's making something of himself. To see that, it gives us motivation and inspiration.
We play our heart out, and we simply enjoy what we do. Okay, the bhajan is a form of seva and sadhana, and they have a very, in fact, I can speak for everyone here, they have passion for this and they enjoy what they do. And when it comes to a bhajan, they're excited. I mean, when you tell them they'll be playing so and so prayer at certain hours or anywhere, they're excited and they're ready to go. The Sri Devam Bhajan group, they're not just the boys or anything, that's they're like brothers, it's a brotherhood. And we take care of each other.
The Ram Bhajan that we host in today is the community prayer. Well, we did host the first one about 2 years ago. It went really well, so the community did ask us to do another one. The reason why we made a community prayer, because not much people can afford the actual Ram Bhajan. As the Bhajan group, we host the Ram Bhajan to help the community. You're more than welcome to call your chance and partake in the prayer.
We've been preparing for the Ram Bhajan for quite some time, from last year, and the community, the donations, sponsors, from the children of the Bhajan group, their parents and friends, relatives, neighbors, and the people from the community, everybody contributed towards this function to make it a success.
You you calling Govinda, Lord Narasimha, to your house, to come in inside your house and bless the house. That's why you call him from the three corner road. The colors represent his torches, his flame, his fire. He can demolish any demon. He can accomplish any win or over any fight. And this light represents such as him bringing to destroying darkness and bringing his own light.
The chants will carry the colors and proceed to the house. And after coming back from the house, they come back to this ring, and then the celebration of Ram will begin, where they sing Ram hymns.
The basis of performing Ram Bhajan is linked very much to the Ramayana. It is the battle Ram and Lakshmana, the brothers, had endured. During the course of the Ram Bhajan, you'll hear a lot of padyams. Padyams is more like prayers, and these are poems that have been written by great saints. I've noticed over the years that the steps gets more and more intricate, it gets more exciting. Different groups have different steps that sets them aside from each other. Bhajan Chetu, we're fortunate to have a brass one. It composes of 16 lamps that would stay lit during the course of the night. That lamps is significant, as I said earlier, with the dispel of good over evil.
Hanuman is one of the biggest devotees to Lord Ram. So wherever is Lord Ram, is Lord Hanuman. So that's why when you partake in the Ram Bhajan, you also give Lord Hanuman's name in chants. There's a lot of sweetmeats, fruits that's offered, especially roti, because of Lord Hanuman. Anything that's offered but without salt, because when you offer prasadam to Lord Vishnu, you don't offer salt.
Vibration of the talams and the drums and the vocals and the music. In that atmosphere where you are transformed as an individual, whether you're playing the instrument or not, and that transformation then puts you into a feeling of greatness, being closer and a step closer to God. But the passion for Ram Bhajan and being in part of any bhajan group, be it in a Ram Bhajan group or a Hari Bhajan group, the passion has grown to the youngsters, and the only way forward for us to keep our culture and to keep our religion to go strong, as it's been passed on from past generations, is for us to educate the youth of today.
I was excited when I heard that I'm stepping in the Bhajan group, stepping in the ring, and because I guess we like play the instruments and sing songs.
Tuning into Sadhana, the Inward Path. Diwali is a time to celebrate the triumph of good over evil, of light over darkness, and knowledge over ignorance. Here in Mzansi, this unique festival also transcends all racial, religious, and class boundaries, truly celebrating our spirit of Ubuntu. And that was our experience at the Etigwini Diwali Festival in Phoenix.
Thank you. The Tikveli Diwali function has been started 3 years ago. The idea of this festival that happens on this Ridal Veil ground by the Tikveli Festival Committee has brought about something that I am proud of, that Hindus across all borders assemble at this particular place and participate in this, bringing signs of oneness. And Diwali is supposed to be that kind of festival, where oneness should be achieved first, then prosperity and all other good reasons follow.
If we actually, all of us, come together in oneness and synergy as Indo organization, then we can experience democratization in the hearts and minds of all of us. God is beyond the limitations of language, religion, caste, color, and creed. And because God is beyond all that, we need to synergize in order to be able to connect with that one God of the universe.
We've brought together about 30 to 40 religious, spiritual, and community organizations in Phoenix to celebrate this Diwali festival for a specific purpose of bringing about unity in the Phoenix area.
We as a human being is an embodiment of light. And also all saints and sages talk about the light that is within us. So even the founder of the Seva Siddhanta Sangam, in one of the beautiful lines, he says, A Jodi Shivude, Jagamolo Jivude, Atalade Dhamma. He says, Lord Shiva, who is the supreme light, dances in this universe as individual lights.
The special spiritual significance of Diwali is the triumph of good over evil, of light over darkness, and that's what the Ramayana depicts. So what this festival speaks about, what the Ramayana speaks about, is how these positive forces, human qualities, and eventually the spiritual divine qualities that are within the heart and the mind and the consciousness of every single person, how these qualities must triumph in the mind, in the consciousness.
So the lighting of the lamps actually brings home to us the message that the Supreme Lord is Jyoti Swarupam, is self-effulgent, is the light of lights, is the Son of Suns. And therefore, we need to connect with the light inside. By manifesting the inner light, we facilitate a transformation from the darkness of ignorance to the light of wisdom, knowledge. And when we experience this, we experience inner peace and inner bliss.
And I think it's been a wonderful experience for everybody to be chanting the Ma mantra and having this unified spirit amongst us.
It's quite important, not just during the time of Diwali, but all the time, to uphold our culture.
It's a time of sharing, giving, and reflecting on what we can do for the community, for the various communities in the world. So that's why we were invited as part of this wonderful float, again rekindling our service to humanity.
I was here today, and I enjoyed the float.
Diwali is universal and it is for everybody. So hence, this function is being brought onto this public ground for the same reason that everybody participates.
Hey!
What magic moments indeed. It was Paramahansa Yogananda who once said, "Live each moment completely and the future will take care of itself. Fully enjoy the wonder and beauty of each moment." And with that, we have come to the end of today's episode. Until next week, stay safe and do keep up your sadhana. Om Shanti.